I started learning Unreal Engine around April 2024, but mind you, the title says 6 months. Let me explain. I did start learning Unreal Engine in April 2024, but I have not been consistent. So I would say approximately I have been learning for 6 months with lots of breaks in between. Just like everyone, I did wanted to try making games as a hobby, but the complex natures of games scared me. And at that time, there were lots of devlogs on YouTube popping up. So I just said, screw it, I will try. And the best part is, just learning Unreal Engine doesn't mean I have to make games. I can make 3D renders, animations, VFX. So it will help me in other skills too. I already have been using Blender, but wasn't really good with it, especially because my renders always look cheap and they still do. Plus, I hate watching this screen. But with Unreal Engine, it does show the visuals directly, and obviously it will not be as good as path tracing, but at least it feels responsive. Around April 2024, I watched a video on how to create environment with Unreal Engine with Megascans. I was able to make something. It still looked very gamey rather than photorealistic. I don't know how the original creator was able to make it look so real. Maybe because I'm using medium quality textures, or maybe my lighting is bad, I don't know. But I know my PC would not be able to handle high quality textures. Then I watch other videos on blueprints, and let me tell you guys, the tutorials of Unreal Engine are not that great. Yes, you will be able to achieve same results, but you will not be able to know why and how it works, or if the methods used are even the best way to do it. For example, lots of tutorials online show using casting, but you shouldn't always use it as it creates hard references. You need to use blueprint interfaces as they create soft references. Basically, in hard references, if one thing stops working, rest will too. But for soft references, they are not coupled or dependent on each other. And again, I did say not always, but there are moments where you can use hard references without any issues. I'm planning to record video tutorials, or rather tutorials for myself, on my other channel. Here I just want to create video notes for myself, but also make them public so that other more experienced developers can correct me if I'm wrong. I then created a 3D platformer with my tiny brain at that time. My goal was to keep expanding on this project whenever I learned something new, kinda like a platformer but to show my progress. But remember guys, this was before I knew about hard references. So this project is completely made with hard references, so I just stopped working on this one. I also tried the new motion graphics update of Unreal Engine, as my goal was to learn to create creative medias and keep making games as a side hobby, which I don't even know if I'll ever reach there. Next, I wanted to try making a product configurator, and I struggled so much on this one. Not to create the interactivity, if that is even a word, but mainly to make the can not look so noisy. I just couldn't figure it out. Even when asking in forums, they said noisiness is just an issue in Unreal. So please let me know if you guys know anything about it. It is a real-time lighting, so maybe it will always have that issue. Maybe, I don't know. This project did teach me a lot about UI widgets and how to connect them, and also how to change cameras. It was fun but very annoying. Next was a bubble trouble project. Between this project and previous project, I was just testing and watching tutorials to get grasp on stuff. I just realized that if I just watch and don't create, it just doesn't help. Instead, making my own notes and trying stuff helped me understand a lot faster. So while watching Reels, a nostalgia video popped up showing a mini clip game called Bubble Trouble. I decided to give it a try, and after working on it for 1 week, I didn't spend like lots of hours on it, but still managed to make this. I already created a video for it on my channel, so please watch it. Again, after this, I stopped working on this because I watched another tutorial series and learned that so many stuff I did in this project were done in like the wrong way, and also I was kinda getting bored of this project. So next, when I was lying down trying to sleep, Suica game randomly just popped in my brain. I just wrote down in my phone, make Suica game in 3D. And that's exactly what my next project was. I did finish this. I modeled and baked all the texture on the fruit. I also tried to bake the lighting because to remove the noisy shadow issues. It kinda worked, but it still doesn't look as good. But I don't know how to make it look like much more cleaner. Also, while making this, I went through lots of bugs. So if you're interested to know more, you can watch this video. Even a game which is so basic would not run at the highest settings in my PC. I don't know why. So maybe if you guys know, please let me know. Also, my games till now have not been frame independent, which is bad by the way. Because you don't want your game logic to be dependent on how much FPS the player has. Around here, I again tried doing some motion graphics, but also tried to integrate blueprint in it, which also feels a bit weird to work with and very confusing to me. And lots of the time I just face like many issues trying to integrate it, but somehow I managed to get it works. Only sometimes though, lots of the time it just gives me bugs. After this, I switched my focus on learning environment art and wanted to go into stylized projects. Turns out, even though I made decent progress on it, I don't understand lots of it. For example, how this material works and why is there so much math in it. This same material is taught by every YouTuber for stylized look, but I don't think anyone even knows how it works. They all just say to add this stuff, add this node, and yeah, it just works sometimes. Sometimes. Oh, I totally forgot about these slimes. This slime, I did try to give it an AI, not the ChatGPT type of AI, but AI controller that Unreal Engine has, which allows to give behavior to the characters. This guy simply moved to a random generated point in limited space. The animation that I wanted to do just didn't work with them, so they just look like this. Turns out making homing missile in Unreal is really simple. They already have a pre-built system for it. So that's exactly what I did. And I had like really fun making this. This already felt like something that can be used in lots of projects, especially platformer games, which I do want to make. These missiles are not perfectly as I wanted them to move, but I guess it's one step closer to that goal. Next, I tried modeling a ballista, which I thought would be impossible, but I took really small steps, one part at a time, and was able to make it. I do have a time lapse on it, and I don't think the way I have made it is the right way to make it, as all the individual parts are disconnected. For nanite also, they need to be connected, I think so, else even if they are in one mesh, the disconnected vertices will not give optimized output for nanite. Obviously, I had to add the ability for the ballista to shoot my player. The ballista basically creates a spear trace, and if the hit actor is the player, then only it shoots the arrow. My last project is this environment work. I wanted to see how long I have made progress than my first project. I did learn some of the nuances, as Unreal Engine has options for both game making and video productions, and obviously knowing which setting to use for game or video production was tough. As for video productions, as it will not be real time, we can use some heavy features, but for games it has to be toned down and we cannot go for super realistic. Even in this latest project, as soon as I added the trees and grass, I was barely able to run the game in 20 FPS. There is something called WPO in materials, and whichever mesh it is applied on, you can move or animate it. All my trees and grass had this, but I still don't know how the creator of this tutorial was able to make this run so smoothly, and obviously his PC was probably like better than mine. I also did remove the WPO later and removed all the trees and grass, added the foliage again, and I was able to get over 50 FPS. But then I later enabled the WPO again and it was still giving me 50 plus FPS. So at this point I just don't know, and maybe one day I'll know and you will too. So just start learning if you're interested. Maybe you might not make games, but rather use these skills for other type of projects. Who knows? I hope you enjoyed my journey till now, and I do plan on creating some video notes on my other channel. So if you want, you could check it out whenever I start making them. And yeah, I'll see you again next time.